Hi everyone, welcome to Chinese Pub. My name is Quillen.
Hi, 大家好，我是 Fiona.
Today's intermediate class is all about infidelity. The husband returns home and the guy is having to hide in the wife's bedroom.
没错，今天要教大家怎么样在一个很紧急的状况之下问问题。So we're going to learn how to ask questions in high-stress situations and also learn some very functional instruction words like...Go crawl over there, go hide over there. So, 爬跟躲这类的词汇。
Okay, well, how about we listen to the situation, the emergency situation?
好，那我们赶紧来听听今天的对话。
好的。
哎呀，你快躲起来，我先生回来了。
啊，躲哪儿呢？床底下。
不行啊。床底下堆满了我新买的鞋子，你爬不进去。
那衣柜呢？
也不成，衣柜里塞满我的衣服，你也挤不进去。
啊，那阳台呢？
哎呦，阳台也不成啊。
阳台挺大的呀，怎么就不成了呢？
那儿已经躲两个人了。
我跳楼算了。
Oh my God.
What's wrong?
Look at this, a legal letter. See? They claim that our product name and website infringes on their trademark.
But we have a registered website and a domain name. But did you ever file a trademark?
They are actually demanding that we sign over our domain name.
Did you know that not having a trademark registration is not only important for the brands and trade names you use for your goods and services, but also for your website? Don't risk losing your domain name and social media pages because of a trademark dispute. The Trademarkers Network of Intellectual Property Attorneys can file your trademark reliably and also give you guidance if someone else before you has filed or registered a trademark with your brand.Go to www.trademarkers.com today to make sure you get the brand protection you deserve.
Okay, so the dialogue starts by saying, Hurry up and hide, my husband has come home.
他说，哎呀，你快躲起来，躲起来。起来 is a common pairing, a common supplement to the verb 躲, 躲。
The verb being to hide.
赶快躲起来。那他就问，躲哪儿呢？躲哪儿呢？
Okay, where can I hide? Under the bed?
好像是大家第一个会想到的地方哦。但不行，因为床下堆满了我新买的鞋子。
Okay, a good word here, which is a pile of things, so like a pile of clothes.
堆满。堆 is to pile, and...Man is full, right? So they've fully piled a space up. 这个地方堆满了鱼。
This place is piled full of fish.
我的衣柜里堆满了衣服。
My clothes closet is piled full of clothes.
那我们今天也会学到塞满。塞 is to jam, to stuff, right? 塞满了，堆满了。两个其实感觉很像，但是还是不太一样。一个是堆, one is to pile up high, sai is to stuff into a space.
Okay, so what is piled up under her bed?
她的床底下堆满了鞋子,她的衣柜里塞满了衣服。
So under the bed is piled up with loads of new shoes, and in the closet, stuffed full of clothing.
那因为床底下堆满了鞋子,她的情人, her lover, 爬不进去。
爬 is, I know this says to climb, like 爬山, to climb a mountain.
好问题 Gwilym, 我们低的地方像我们要爬进一个洞或是一个很小的地方我们也会说爬。
So when we're going into a small space, we also use the verb 爬。
Okay, so basically anything you're using all four limbs to kind of crawl around.
Yes, so I would say when your chest is close to the ground, so you can imagine when you're climbing up a steep mountain, you're using all four limbs and your torso is quite close to the ground. Same when you're crawling, right? So in Chinese, 爬, 它可以是 crawl 的意思, 它也可以是 climb 的意思。
Now, what's the issue with getting into the clothes closet? He can't squeeze in, right?
他挤不进去，挤不进去。
So, 挤 is the adjective to be squashed or squeezed.
Or squeezed. 所以如果你要喝牛乳，你需要挤牛乳。If you want to drink milk, you have to squeeze the milk, right, from a cow.
And the verb complement here is 挤不进去。
挤进去，挤不进去。塞进去，塞不进去。
So, unable to get in. So, finally, how about the balcony, which is literally the sun platform?
阳台，他最后就想到阳台哦。但阳台好像也不能去。里面这个女生她说不成啊。
不成 ？Not like I guess unable to complete.
不成，不可以，不能够完成这个任务。You can't accomplish this task, right? 不成，不成。
Okay, so why can't you go on the balcony?
一个那么大的阳台为什么不成呢？因为那儿已经躲了两个人了。
Okay, so there are already two people hiding on the balcony.
没错。那最后他就开玩笑说，我跳楼算了。跳楼是什么意思呢？
That is the verb to jump off a building.
跳楼。当然这整堂课都是开玩笑的。Of course, this whole lesson is a joke, but I think it was a great lesson to learn verbs such as 爬,
to crawl,
挤,
to be squeezed,
塞,
to be stuffed,
还有堆,
to be piled.
最后呢，还有最重要的就是躲。
躲, third tone is the word to hide.
Hide, 赶快。躲起来。And if you're wondering how to say hide and seek in Chinese, 我们会说躲猫猫。
To hide from the cat?
Hide like a cat.、
Ah.
躲猫猫。好，那说到这儿呢，我们就赶紧再来听一遍今天的对话。
哎呀，你快躲起来，我先生回来了。
啊，躲哪儿呢？床底下。
不行啊。床底下堆满了我新买的鞋子，你爬不进去。
那衣柜呢？
也不成，衣柜里塞满我的衣服，你也挤不进去。
啊，那阳台呢？
哎呦，阳台也不成啊。
阳台挺大的呀，怎么就不成了呢？
那儿已经躲两个人了。
我跳楼算了。
Greetings, everyone, and welcome to Chinese Pod Trivia. Our first question is, how long will it take you to become an intermediate Chinese speaker using the Chinese Pod app? Is it A, the rest of your life? B, you should already be an intermediate speaker? C, 3 months? Or D, Chinese Pod has an app?
You should already be in...
Ooh, that is incorrect.The correct answer is C, 3 months. That's right. Head over to ChinesePod.com now to register for your access to over 4,000 lessons. Get the ChinesePod app now on Google Play or the App Store.
Gwilym 常常觉得我的衣柜都塞满了衣服，都堆满了东西。
Yeah, Fee's closet is... Well, we've literally just moved house out to the suburbs. And
I would say my cupboards are quite tidy, and it's your cupboards that are always full of things.
老是塞满了东西，堆满了衣服。我们的猫咪都爬不进去，也挤不进去。
Our cats can neither stuff themselves in or crawl their way in.
Okay, well, hopefully you don't have to use this class in future, but lots of really interesting and useful, very descriptive adjectives and verbs.
We hope you don't get the opportunity to practice this exact scenario, but there are loads of useful verbs specifically in today's lesson that are definitely worth practicing.
好，那希望你喜欢我们今天的课程，我们就下次见，
再见。
As usual, ChinesePod provides an extensive selection of learning materials for this lesson on its website, www.chinesepod.com. You can access this lesson directly with the lesson number 4063. So just go to www.chinesepod.com/4063 and you will find a transcript, vocabulary, and much more.The link again, www.chinesepod.com/4063. ChinesePod, ChinesePod.